Thank you very much. Dear President, dear colleagues, let me start by thanking the Hellenic Parliament and especially Mr. Tasoulas for the wonderful organization of this European Conference of Presidents of Parliament. It's truly a pleasure to be here in Athens, the birthplace of democracy, and to experience the Greek hospitality. I have recently been elected in April of this year as the Speaker of the Dutch House of Representatives, and I welcome this opportunity provided by the Hellenic Parliament and by the PACE to meet so many of my European colleagues today. Our democracies, and more especially our parliaments, have faced most serious challenges during the COVID-19 public health crisis, as presented as well by the keynote speakers. Upholding the Council of Europe standards of democracy, human rights, and the rules of law has always been a challenging since the founding of our organization, but perhaps never more than in the past 1.5 years. In the Dutch House of Representatives, there was one thing that was paramount when the pandemic fully reached our country in March last year. Our scrutinizing role in government should remain intact. Democracy may never come to a standstill, especially not when times are tough. So we did everything to keep up our constitutional role in overseeing governmental actions. What started with advices to wash hands quickly evolved into new logistical arrangements to ensure that crucial parliamentary debates could take place on the COVID measures taken by the government, like the introduction of a controversial curfew. Committee work initially was put on the back burner. Only committees of inquiry were allowed to continue their work with all important hearings. Furthermore, we ensured that media could continue its works and that journalists could attend debates. In a free democracy, the media can never be locked out, not even when society is in lockdown due to pandemic. Allowing representatives of the media to attend debates was even more crucial as we concluded that we had to temporarily ban the public from our parliament. We do believe that in an open and transparent democracy, as we have in the Netherlands, the public gallery should always be filled. However, sanitary restrictions made this a physical impossibility. But the public could still follow debates through the live streams. In line with the new provisions that the Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe developed for holding hybrid and remote meetings, in the Dutch House of Representatives, we also developed methods and procedures for remote committee meetings. Before COVID-19, we did not have committee meetings by video. But over the past 1.5 years, it has proven to be a keystone in ensuring that our parliament can fulfill its role as guarantor of democracy in times of crisis. Unlike PACE, we have not yet developed facilities for online voting and a digital quorum. We managed the COVID crisis without this so far, but we are studying this issue to see whatever the increased flexibility it would provide could be fitted into constitutional requirements. While the House of Representatives in the future continuing using any of the new working methods that we developed during the crisis, I think hybrid working is here to stay, both for our MPs and their staff. It provides people with the opportunity to create more balance between work life and family life. And that will be appreciated also once COVID is no longer a crisis. Hybrid working even bring a stimulus to interparliamentary relations, as it will allow more parliamentarians to get involved in meetings of, for example, PACE of another assemblies without having to leave their parliamentary business back home unattended. With this, I don't mean to devalue in-person contact. Meetings in real life will always have added value over video meetings. But if COVID-19 has brought our democracy one good thing, it is that it has taught us how to work in a more flexible way while still living up to our fundamental values and principles. I thank you for your attention.